Good morning, students. I am Mayank Tiwari. Today we will solve test number 24 of the General Agriculture series. Let's start. Please, students, write down the numbers 1 to 10 and then evaluate your correct answer at the end of the test for self-evaluation. Let's start. Question number 1. Upma wheat is option A, Triticum durum, option B, Triticum vulgare, option C, Triticum diacocum, option D, Triticum aestivum. Student, this is a very basic question. You ought to remember it. This emmer wheat is Triticum diacocum. It is also called upma wheat. Triticum durum or durum wheat is macaroni wheat. Bread wheat is Triticum aestivum. Sometimes it is given and sometimes it is given Triticum vulgare, but most of the time it is Triticum aestivum only. So bread wheat, you remember Triticum aestivum and Triticum vulgare both. Indian dwarf wheat is Triticum spherococcum, and Mexican dwarf wheat is Triticum aestivum. Please, student, remember these. Any student, please remember the chromosome number of some of the important species of Triticum, like Triticum species agilploids, and your monococcum has 2n is equal to 14. 2n is equal to 28 is present in durum and diacocum, and Triticum spelta, Triticum macha, Triticum vulgare, Triticum aestivum has 2n is equal to 22. Please, student, remember these. Student, next question again from agronomy. When main axis stops growing and the growth of branches exceed the main axis. Option A, monopodial. Option B, racemose. Option C, cymose. Option D, both A and B. You have to tell what is this condition called. When main axis stops growing and growth of branches exceed the main axis. Students, here is the diagram. First is cymose. You see the figure 8.1. First is cymose inflorescence. Second is your racemose inflorescence. So what is sympodial or cymose inflorescence? When main axis stops growing and the growth of branches exceed the main axis, it is called sympodial or cymose, the first one, which was the correct answer. And it is found in cotton. Please remember it. Monopodial and sympodial. These all are inflorescences found in cotton. Please remember it. And your monopodial or racemose inflorescence, when main axis continues growing and gives off lateral branches, we do not exceed its size. Example, cotton stem branches. These are your monopodial or racemose. Please remember. And student, please remember, flower bud in cotton, it is called square, and H4 is the first commercial cotton hybrid developed by C.T. Patel in 1970. This is very important, students, please remember it. And student, in cotton, you ought to remember some important instrument also, like staple length is measured by ball/shorter, fineness is measured by micronear, and micronear gives average weight of fiber in microgram, and one is arillometer. Maturity of fiber is judged by arillometer, please remember it. Student, question number 3. If the natural cross-pollination percentage is 26 to 50%, then isolation distance is. Student, this question I have repeated many times. You ought to remember that table. If the natural cross-pollination percentage is 26 to 50%, it is given and you have to tell what is the isolation distance. Option A, 100 to 200 meter. Option B, 200 to 300 meter. Option C, 300 to 500 meter. Option D, 500 to 1000 meter. Student, please remember this table. Many of the questions are asked from it. Natural cross-pollination percentage is 0 to 10%, 11 to 25%, 26 to 50%, 51 to 75%, 75 to 100. Less all are on the difference of 25-25. Only first is on the difference of 10. 0 to 10%, if there is natural cross-pollination percentage, isolation distance is 100 to 200. If natural cross-pollination percentage is 11 to 25, then the isolation distance is 200 to 300. If the natural cross-pollination percentage is 26 to 50, then the isolation distance is 300 to 500. If the natural cross-pollination percentage is 51 to 675, the isolation distance is 500 to 1000 meter. If the natural cross-pollination percentage is 76 to 100%, then the isolation distance is more than 1 kilometer. Please remember it. And student, please remember the isolation distance from some of the important field crop like wheat, barley, oat, it is 3 meter. For pearl millet hybrid, for foundation seed, it is 1000 meter, and for certified seed, it is 200 meter. Rapeseed mustard, 50 for self-incompatible, 50 for self-compatible and 100 for self-incompatible. For foundation seed and for certified seed, 25 for self-compatible and 50 for self-incompatible. Do not go in that much detail, only remember some basics. Like for tomato, 50-25, it is very important and easy to remember. Like cabbage is a highly cross-pollinated crop, so 1600 for foundation seed and for certified seed, it is 1000 meter. Please remember it, and rest all are easy, you can remember. But field crops, all the self-pollinated crop, wheat, barley, oat, this is most important, this you remember. For onion also you remember, 1500, and tomato 50 and 25, these three you remember students, these are very important. Student, question number 4, 1 hectare of seed crop in seed plot technique of potato gives dash hectare of commercial crop. Student, seed plot technique, I told you many times, it is found in potato. Important is name of the person. There are two techniques which are very confusing in potato, which is TPS, true potato seed, and second is seed plot technique. Seed plot technique was given by Pushkar Nath and true potato seed was given by Ramanujan. Please student remember it, do not get it wrong. So exact answer you remember it, question number B, option number B, 10 to 15 hectare is correct answer of this question. If you are growing 1 hectare of seed crop by seed plot technique in potato, you will get 10 to 15 hectare of commercial crop. Please student remember it. Question number 5, which of the following herbicide is pre-plant applied? Option A, 2,4-D, option B, dicot, option C, alachlor, option D, fluchlorin. So student, this is again very basic fundamental question, all of you must have done it correctly, but still, pre-plant applied herbicide are fluchlorin and alachlor, pre-emergence herbicide are only selective herbicide, and post-emergence herbicide is 2,4-D, propanil, dicot, paracot, dalapon. Please students remember them. Student, question number 6, have a look. Scientific name of little bee. Student, this is from apiculture. Apis florea, Apis dorsata, Apis mellifera, Apis serrana. Student, these all you must have read and studied. So student, here it is. The book I am using is Handbook of Agriculture by ICAR. Little bee is Apis florea, which was the correct answer in the question. Please student also remember, the honey production per colony is 200 to 250 gram. Second is rock bee, it is Apis dorsata, and 50 kg per colony you can find. And Indian bee is Apis serrana indica, 12 to 15 kg per hive per annum is the annual production. And another is western bee, it is also called European bee, it is Apis mellifera, it is the best species of honey bee, please remember it. And student, please remember, rock bee is Apis dorsata and it is not rearable, it is not domesticated, it is wild bee, please remember it. Student, look at question number 7, scientific name of teosinte. Option A, Zea mexicana, option B, Vigna umbellata, option C, Trigonella finum gratium, option D, Trifolium respinatum. Student, this is very simple question, actually, if you know what is teosinte. What is teosinte? Teosinte is the progenitor of maize, so its scientific name will be Zea mexicana automatically. Rest all you remember. Here are some important botanical names which you ought to remember. Like Berseem, Egyptian clover, it is Triflorium alexandrium. Lucerne or Alfalfa is Medicago sativa. Sweet clover is Senji, Medicago indica. Then Shaftal or Persian clover, Trifolium respinatum, which I gave in the option. This Methi or Fenugreek, it is Trigonella phenogratium. Please remember it. Lobia or Cowpea is Vigna aguiculata. Guar or cluster bean is Cymopsis tetragonoloba, from which you make guar gum. Rice bean is Vigna umbellata. Please student remember it, this is important. Oat or jai, you remember, this is Avena sativa. Jowar or barley is Hodium vulgare. Cherry or sorghum is sorghum bicolor. Bajra or pearl millet is Pennisetum glaucum. Makka or maize is Zea maize. Makcherry or teosinte, which I asked in the question, and it is the correct answer, Zea mexicana. And chara sarso or Chinese cabbage is Brassica pekinensis. This is your important forage crop. All these are important forage crop. Please remember them. Student, question number 8, you see. Tassar silkworm is option A, Anthria myelata, option B, Anthria proloi, option C, Anthria asamensis, option D, none. Student, this is again very important question from sericulture. They always ask the botanical name, the scientific name of some of the silkworm, only the scientific name and their host worm, host trees you remember. So student, here it is. Scientific name of Tassar silkworm is Anthria myelata. Please remember it. And its host plant are Terminalia arjuna, Arjun tree. Pannagar students would have seen it. It is near the Badi market. When you go to Badi market, all the Arjun belt is there. And this Terminalia tomentosa and Shoria robusta, these are the host plant for Tassar silkworm, which is Anthria myelata. Second is student, your temperate Tassar, Anthria proloi, and this feeds on oak leaves, remember. Third is student, your Airy silkworm, this feeds on arundi, which is called castor. So the scientific name of castor is Ricinus communis. So its scientific name is Samia ricini, related to castor, or Phylloxamia ricini. Please, student, remember it. Host plant, castor, you know, for airy silkworm. And Kesadu is another important plant, Payam. And Borpat and Borkesharu, these are all the botanical name. You only remember castor only. Only castor they ask. Maximum they will ask what is the scientific name of airy silkworm. You remember it. And student, last is Muga culture, Muga silkworm actually. Its scientific name is Anthria assamensis, and its host plant are Som, Maxillus bombicin, or Listia polyantha. These you remember. Som or Solu are the important host plants for Muga silkworm. Please remember it. Option 9, student. Question number 9, students. Citrate and water soluble fertilizer. Citrate and water insoluble fertilizer, you have to tell. Students, option A is MAP, monoammonium phosphate. Option B is basic slag. Option C is raw bone meal. Option D is DCP. So what is the citrate and water insoluble fertilizer in them? Student, this I also told you many times. Some phosphatic fertilizer are water soluble, some are citrate soluble and water insoluble, and some are citrate and water insoluble both. So water soluble fertilizer is your single superphosphate, double superphosphate, triple superphosphate, monoammonium phosphate, diammonium phosphate. These all are water soluble fertilizer. Citrate soluble fertilizer are DCP, Thomas slag or basic slag, and Rhenia phosphate. And citrate and water insoluble fertilizer is raw phosphate, raw bone meal, steam bone meal. Please remember, students. Student, last but not the least, white bud of maize is caused by deficiency of. You have to tell which of the following nutrient is responsible for causing white bud of maize. Option A, zinc. Option B, boron. Option C, calcium. Option D, manganese. Student, this is very important question. In 2017 JRF exam, it was asked. So you remember some of the important physiological disorder. Like white bud of maize is caused by zinc. Khaira is caused by zinc deficiency. This boron deficiency causes hollow stem of cauliflower, browning of cauliflower curd, top sickness of tobacco, hard fruit of citrus. These are all caused by boron deficiency. Manganese deficiency, you also remember, gray speck of oat, pahala blight of sugarcane, complete intravenous chlorosis, it is caused by manganese. Student, yellow spot of citrus, hard fruit of citrus is called by boron, and the yellow spot of citrus is called by molybdenum. Whiptail of cauliflower, this is, student, I do not know why it is so important. It is asked infinite number of time, every paper you see, whiptail of cauliflower, it is called red disease caused by molybdenum. And copper, for copper you have rosette and axis gumming, which is the main melanin plants. So student, that's all for today. I hope this video will be useful to you. If it is useful, please share with your fellow batchmates and other juniors. And you have any complaint, any confusion with regard to any content of the video, please message me. And please write down your score in the last for self-evaluation. Thank you, students.